So tonight I've got a very special group of people on the panel tonight. We have some current basketball players and some former basketball players, but nonetheless, a group of people that are passionate about basketball. So if you're a basketball fan, this segment is for you. But before we get into it, you know how we do. If you have your favorite libation, raise them up, and we're about to get into it. Straight no chaser. Salute, gentlemen. Which, by the way, I'm so impressed with the young guys, even though they're of age to drink, but they chose to drink water. So kudos to them. Way to take care of your bodies, guys. Doug got the 41. I've had a couple 30-point games. So to guys like Big Frenchie and Derek and Ken and guys that can go out there and average 25 points, 30 points, 40 points, man, that's a big feat. I give my hats off because I know I was winded. I was exhausted after that. You know,
that was about how many shots it is. One game. Yeah.
Hey, Stan, I've only scored 40 points in one game in my whole life. So
that was my only 40 points game, too.
And that is that I give it up to anybody who can go out there and do that consistently. Like, I mean, that's a crazy feat, especially trying to play point guard, man, and you scoring like that is just a hot night. You know what I'm saying? And that was in our playoff game before we played y'all, Arnell, in that league. When I killed whatever team that was. I can't even remember what team it was because it was like a blur. The ball was just going.
It was the black team.
Yeah.
All I know is to go out there and score 40 points consistently, you are different.
Yes.
James Harden.
Yep.
James Harden is different. Michael Jordan is different. Them some different type of cats. They go out and score 40 a night. That's crazy. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy, man.
And you have to have a certain mental makeup to be able to go out there and score 30 or 40 a night, because that's not easy. The physical part is huge, but just the mental makeup to go out there and go score 30 or 40.
Dog, my high game was 47, and I thought I was shooting too much. And the guard kept giving me the rock, and he was just like, dog, you hot. Just keep going. And like Derek said, and you said too, Stan, I looked at the box score at the end of the game, and I was like, man, that. And then I started thinking about it. Like, cats going out there averaging 35, 36 points a game. How do they do it every night to score 30, to score that much?
So. I mean, when you talking about pickup or something like that, that's one thing. But with referees and, timeouts and, just all the things that go and playing with in a league game to go out there and score 40, that's something. And I was like, I can't never shoot that much no more, man. I mean, that was like ridiculous. Like, I shot the ball literally, and I'm trying to get people involved. They giving me the ball back because I'm hot. You know what I'm saying? So if I throw the ball, because Kevin Lauder was on my squad, right?
So yeah, you had scores.
I'm throwing the ball to Kevin as many times as I can, and he tossing it back to me. So I'm letting it go. And it's, man, I'm like, man. I would never say that I was one of those type of scorers because I didn't have that type of mentality, you know. But I could score the ball, but I ain't had that type of mentality, man. Exactly. When you can say I'm going out here and I'm shooting 25 rocks a night, you something else, brother.
And to be able to do that with the volume of games that they do and then back to back, travel and all that other stuff, it really makes it interesting. Make you wonder how they really prepare their bodies like that.
Man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's something else, man.
When I hear guys say, Kobe scored 81. Well, look who he's playing against. I tell guys now, I could drop you in a gym with some high schoolers or an eighth graders, and you wouldn't score 81 points.
Never. You're talking about a
different mental makeup as well as the physical ability to make shots.
Man, I told the cat, you didn't know how hard it is. I can drop you in the gym by yourself and give you 40 minutes, and it'd be hard for you to score 81.
Hey, I'm with you. Hey, it's a video out there right now with Jabba on the west side. And, I can't remember the park. It's Tony Bennett's park where Tony be hooping all the time.
You tell me he over there at Newberry.
And he went out there and scored 73. You remember that? He scored 73 points. I said, you still ain't stopped, man. You old and you still shooting that much.
In a game?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he scored 73 in a league game.
Damn.
I can't shoot that much.
Me either.
No. I mean, it takes a different mentality for somebody to shoot like that, man. I said, dog, you still shooting like, and I've been with him my whole life. I've been with Jabba my whole life. And I said, you still shooting like that, man. You in your 40s. You still shooting. He scored 73. He was in his 40s.
Well, I mean, you know, that he just lives basketball. So, but you know what, guys? We can continue all night talking basketball because this is something that we've all done or are doing that we're passionate about. We had some great conversation around the NBA season coming back. Should high-level Division I athletes consider HBCUs as part of their recruiting? And then also being able to share some of our street ball basketball playground experiences. This has been a great segment.